Lucy, but also the class teachers, Jacob Tamara, and Daniel as well, thanks very much. And also acknowledge the work that Liv and Dan. Enjoy the proceedings tonight. On behalf of the School Council, I thank you for your attendance, your perseverance, for respecting the school values, and again, on behalf of the School Council, I wish you all the best in your future endeavours. I know that Coburg Primary has given you the foundation to grow as students and as humans in Melbourne, and I wish you, on behalf of the Council, again, all the best of luck. Everything that you want to do in the future. So let's get up for the class.
Thank you, Jacob, for that wonderful speech. Now let's welcome our principal, Matt, to the stage.
Thanks everyone. Before I start, I also would like to acknowledge that we are meeting on the lands of the Wurundjeri people and pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. Well, it's been a day, I have to say, inside, outside, looking at the weather, that I'm actually really glad we're inside here, and after speaking to some of the parents, I think it's a little bit poetic that we're back in where it all started for some of your children back in the junior school, so it's good to be here. But as principal of the primary school, Coburg Primary School, I stand proudly before you to officially welcome you to our Year 6 graduation. And as I said, what a year it has been. I cannot believe we're so close to the end. And it almost feels this year the time has warped. It's been short and it's been long and it's just really stretched together. But as I said, I'm so glad that we're here and we're doing this face to face. It's not where the laughter. But again, we're face to face. Now, firstly, I'd like to say how incredibly proud we are of the young people who sit in front of us. Let's give them a round of applause. A group with a strong sense of justice and a high level of empathy and loyalty to one another, all mixed in with some Coburg flair. To think about these kids as little preppies on the junior school with Jolly, Sarah and Nick, 2016 to now. We as a staff, from our teachers, to our ES staff, to our office staff, we all talk about leaving a legacy. With the aim of being role models and wanting to be that special person to you kids. I hope that over your schooling journey, that you're able to find that special person, someone who you'll remember, made a difference to you during your time at Coburg. Whether it was a favourite teacher, whether it was an educational support person, whether it was an agri-al maintenance person, whoever it was, I hope that all of you know that you're loved. And that I hope Coburg Primary School has given you fond memories that will stay with you forever. It's important to celebrate these milestones, as Jacob was saying, and tonight's celebration would not be possible without the hard work and organisation of so many people. Firstly, I'd like to thank Daniel, Jacob, Tamara, Nib, Dane, and our office staff, and all of our PS who have helped make tonight possible. Can we give them a round of applause? Next, I'd like to thank you, our families. Thank you for choosing this school. Thank you for putting your trust in us to teach and help grow your child. The following families are parting ways from the school. Callum's family, Panayotis' family, Caitlin's family, Oliver's family, Tessa's family, Rafi's family, Alexa's family, Lily's family, Oscar's family, Adelaide's family, not really, Jolly's teacher's family, Zed's family, Jack's family, Archie's family, Abby's family, Ayusha's family, Finn's family, Eli's family, Noah's family, Oscar's family, Yen's family, Rita's family, and Marisha's family. And when you hear that list, that's a lot of families who are leaving our community, and I just want to thank you so much for everything you've done for our school. Big round of applause for those families. said earlier, this group has a strong sense of justice and a high level of empathy and loyalty to one another. This group has been instrumental in leading the development of our new school values this year. And this is a pretty special thing. I don't know if you realise this, but it's very special because these kids are leaving a legacy for the next chapter of Coburg Primary School. Now, I've been thinking of some stories that come to mind when I think of this group. And some of the stories that come to my mind when I think of this group. The first one, I think about Oscar Kay sitting out next to Agar, our maintenance man's car, for his entire lunchtime one day because Agar had surgery on his shoulder. And Oscar sat outside his car all day waiting to help Agar. I think about the students who started with us as preps and their deep connections to the school. Paddy Ozzie actually told Lucy yesterday that his family began here in the 80s with his dad going to school. I haven't proof checked that. Is that yes? Oh, we'll pass it. Okay. Thank you. I also saw yesterday the value of empathy. I saw our current school captains showing a strong sense of empathy. And when they began to well up, when they had to deliver the news to the unsuccessful candidates, the next year's school captains, they started to cry because they were so upset delivering that. But I was so proud of them the way that they were able to push through that. I also think back to camp a few weeks ago. Lucy and I went to the full camp and we're still recovering now, but I'm so glad that we're able to go to camp. But I think back to camp a few weeks ago. Leading into the camp, we were really worried about our Year 3 students because they'd never been to camp before. And we were worried that there was on the first night, the teachers were preparing for a lot of tears from our Year 3 students as they'd never been away and possibly missing home. It got to 9 o'clock on the first night and we looked at our Year 3s and they were happy as Larry. And we looked across at our Year 6s and they were all bawling. They were talking about school finishing and they didn't want to leave school. Well, we had to send them all to bed, they all went to bed, they all asked to go to bed, and they were all a complete mess. I even think about a group of students who every now and then will huddle around on the basketball court before school as they secretly disperse lollies purchased from Fat Harry's on City Road. I know about that. I don't think you got away with that. And I also think about a bit of a quirky story. Because Coburg, we love and celebrate quirky. And on camp, I was with a group at the Penguin Parade. And Zed and Lily were with me for about 30 minutes. And as we're leaving the Penguin Parade, the entire time they were asking me if I would go into the gift shop and purchase them a penguin for the whole time. But not only that, I wasn't conceding to their request. They continued to then offer up their souls. Now, I considered it for about 30 minutes. I thought, well, it wouldn't be bad. It's two souls, but no, I decided not to. But anyway, last week, Lily and Zed came up to me with a Christmas present wrapped up, and Lily had actually spent her weekend going around to thrift shops to buy me a little penguin, which she wrapped up in a present. So, these are the stories, and I've not captured all the students there, but I just want to give you a bit of a tone of the group we have, a group that care for each other. Now, this is for you. If Coburg has taught you anything, let it be this. Be whoever you want to be. Do whatever you want to do. Find your passion. Work hard. Do it well. And always, always be kind. Step forward. Put yourself into wobbly ground. Put your hand up. It does not matter what anyone else thinks. We wish you all the best for high school. Thank you.
Before we get started, just on behalf of Jacob, Daniel and myself, we just want to congratulate you all on finishing primary school. We're also incredibly proud of you, not just for your work with us this year, but also for all the years of primary school you've had. So let's give them a big clap before we get started. As we call up each of the students tonight, they're going to read a stanza from a poem that they've written about themselves. Firstly, we have Paniotti. Next, we have Oscar H.
I am loyal and adventurous. I wonder if high school will be fun. I hear the laughs and tears of my mates. I see the finish line as I show into high school. I want to see my mates, but I go into different towns. I'm loyal and adventurous.
Callum unfortunately can't be with us tonight, but we wish Callum the best. He's watching from Lewis. So can we give Callum a really big hand up? Right, I'm going to read the first stanza of Callum's poem for him. I am curious and concise. I wonder what it's like with people without ADHD. I hear the shapes of trees growing in my mind. I see adorable floaty things called guinea pigs. I want an end to world poverty. I'm curious and concise. Next we have Lily.
I'm creative and artistic. I wonder what high school will be like. I hear the cheering of people as I walk down the stairs. I see the stage where I have to do a dance at the end of the year. I'll make friends in high school. I'm creative and artistic.
Zed.
I am happy and confident. I wonder what the future is like. I hear kids' voices in the playground. I see red and black uniforms as I walk through the school gates for the last time. I want to live a long, healthy life. I am happy and confident.
Next we have Jack Wilson.
I am active and resilient. I pretend I'm inside my book. I feel the bush brush in my face. I touch the tree trunks. I worry I forget where to go in high school. I cry about rain. I'm active and resilient.
And next we have Abigail Pratt.
I am passionate and determined. I wonder what my life will be like in high school. I hear music playing on repeat in my head. I see my chickens playing in my backyard. I want us to make a new lifetime friends in high school.
I'm passionate for children. Next we have Finn Robertson.
I am loyal and colorful. I wonder will I make friends in high school? I hear the laughs of my past go through my ears. I see my peers stand before me and I smile. I want a hairless cat. I am loyal and colorful.
Next we have Eloise Shockhill.
Stay the same. I am stubborn and enthusiastic. And next we have Noah Tory Lady. Next we have Ruby White.
I am determined and fascinated. I wonder what the world would be like in 30 years. I hear the bottom of the ocean. I see the end of the universe. I want to have a joyful life. I am determined and fascinated.
And next we have ACA.
Playing soccer, cheering and shouting. I can see the light of change as I finish my last day of primary school. I want to have a good life. I am friendly and energetic.
Those are all the students from 5-6-8. Can we give them one more big clap, please?
Thank you. Bonnie and Karen.
Let's welcome Rita to this stage.
I resisted the will. I wonder what the world will be like when I'm an adult. I hear the country of dead leaves on their foot. I see possums eating a long path in it. I want to go to perform. I resisted the will.
Please welcome Eli.
I am lazy and confused. I wonder what high school will be like. I hear the most random things exactly the same motive. I see myself going to bed and go, I want from these $3, and I'm lazy and confused.
Finally, can we welcome Savannah to the stage?
I'm autistic and kind. I wonder what it's like to cover up high school. I hear kids playing in the yard. I see my friends playing with each other. I want to be me and have equal rights. I'm autistic and kind.
Let's hear it for 5-6-8 one more time.
Thank you, Daniel. Next we have Jacob presenting the graduating students from 6C. Thank you.
Okay, just before we start, just like to say congratulations everyone. 6C, being wonderful to teach the student and you're all great people with so many great qualities, so congratulations again for leading your primary years of schooling. First of all, I'd like to call up Zach to say.
I'm funny and athletic. I wonder why this stuff is so hard to think of. I hear Finn in the background while I ride this. I see my iPad screen. I want it double. I am funny and athletic.
I am smart and sporty. I wonder if my parents are proud of me. I hear my parents cheering me on.
see everybody playing together. I want to be happy. I'm smart and sporty.
Next up, we have Archie.
I'm athletic and creative. I wonder what high school feel like. I hear my music through my headphones. I see nature. I want to go on a holiday. I'm athletic and creative.
Congratulations, Abel.
I see the playground. I want to be happy in life. I'm friendly.
Congratulations to you again.
I'm athletic and funny. I wonder what the future will look like. I hear planes flying over houses. I see outer space. I want success. I'm athletic and funny.
And last of all, we have Rungi.
I am driven but always hungry. I pretend I'm not worried about things. I feel excited about my life at high school. I touch the keys of a piano waiting to play. I worry that my later life will be frightening. I am driven but always hungry.
We have another round of applause for the graduating class.
They conduct themselves throughout school levels. We'll be announcing the Arts, Music, Sports, Academic Excellence in our music.
Can I please call Nick to present the Arts Award?
Hi, everybody. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all of these wonderful young people on their awesome self-portraits around the room. Notice them? They look amazing and they reflect their hard work over the last 5 weeks. There's so much creative talent amongst these people. It's really hard to choose this award today. But tonight, I'm giving the Visual Arts Award to someone who is all in at each art lesson, who demonstrates technical skill and creative thought in their concepts and processes. Their work in portraiture this year has been a standout. Can everyone put their hands together for Edie Adelaide?
Can I please call Jane to present the music award?
Thanks again to all these amazing sixes for seeing happy and that self-made war cry, which I thought was amazing. Make it a clap for that war cry. This award goes to someone who has shown exceptional enthusiasm in music. Their dedication motivates me to be a better teacher and motivates others to perform to the best of their ability. She's always keen and it's almost impossible to get her out of the music room sometimes, and that's Caitlin.
Daniel present the sports award. Oh no. I was going to make something up and Tim has sent something through. The recipient of this year's PE award is a star both on and off the field. Not only in this individually extremely talented from a sporting perspective, but consistently displays the school values of respect and courage. A wonderful leader who always leads by example. This person is always willing to have a go and never leaves anything behind. This individual has represented the school with distinction on many occasions, including representing CPS at the district swimming championships, missing divisional representation by the smallest of margins, a top 10 finish in cross country, a first and third place in the district athletics, and was a member of the All Girls Conquering Soccer Team. It is a pleasure to announce the winner as Halloween.
Thank you.
applause from all the colleagues who will present the Mall of Glass Community Award.
Hi everyone, this is a very special award for, it's actually the Merribeck Community Citizenship Police Award. It was a very tough decision, but this year's well deserved going to Abigail Frank.
Thanks for coming, and we hope you enjoyed the ceremony.
Everyone else will get to walk down that one last time so we can all give it the cheer that you deserve.